ready, Johnny. Just thought I'd come up here on the 190 Beast. First of all then, the lack of content has purely been because I've been injured. I hurt my calf, I got a calf tear, 19 centimeters, and it was nearly a rupture, but luckily there was a few fibers still stuck together. But anyway, what I had to do there is just put my health before pit bike content. So it was a bit of a nightmare really. I couldn't drive, I couldn't work, I was out of action for quite a few months. So you can see why I didn't want to come off roading or do any of this sort of stuff in case I just made myself worse. Obviously I got a house and a family. It became quite difficult, so I really had to make sure I was pretty well recovered, if you know what I mean. I wouldn't say I'm 100% recovered yet, but we're getting there. That happened at the end of October, so it's been quite a long time since I have done any pit bike stuff. But my plan today was just quickly come up, explain the situation, give this bike a once over. I dragged it out the container and obviously I put it away when I was injured because I knew I couldn't do anything. And I thought the battery was going to be absolutely knackered. I put it on the trickle charge for a couple of days and it fired straight up. That's the original battery still. The only real bad point, because I put it away dirty, was the chain had a bit of surface rust. I cleaned it off and lubed it up with some GT85 and it looks all right. But I do want to change my sprockets and chain sometime in the near future. So I haven't sold any of my pit bikes, as you can tell. It's just literally been a bit of a blip on the channel for some time. But these things happen, and you have to put yourself before anything else, especially when you've got a young family. And now there's another thing that's a bit of a pain in the butt. I cleared this wood, got it all ready to ride, and I got this massive great tree come down right across one of the main trails. I don't want to fall in this ditch, but look at that. Look at the size of that. My chainsaw's never that big. And that's across a bank. There's going to be a lot of pressure when you're cutting. It's just a... there's a lot of work there. There's a day's work. And then as you're on all these banks, you can't get any machinery down to help you. So literally, you've just got to cut it and move it. And there's going to be a lot of wood. So if anyone wants any wood, hit me up and you can come and get it yourself. Chop it up and remove it yourself. And maybe give the Motor Machines channel a little donation. So as well as cutting off that trail, there's also another well-used trail just along there. And that's got loads of branches on it too. And then this one, you'll never get up here now. Just a lot of clearing. Bit of a nightmare if I'm honest. But there you go. Keeping this woods up together takes a lot of work. A lot of time that no one sees. You could hardly walk around it, it's just covered with stinger nettles. So now I'm just going to have a go on my bike. I am a little bit nervous. I am going to be weary. I'm not going to be giving it too much, but there's plenty of options in here. And I tell you what, just getting back on that seat and riding up here just brought back all the reasons why I love pit biking. I think I was a little bit apprehensive about getting back on it. I was thinking, you know. But then the smile that put on my face, I knew straight away I'd made the right decision. Currently, right now, at this moment in time, hopefully it's not going to change. I'm just going to go for a little ride then around the woods, see what's about, give the bike a little bit of a workout, and go from there. Bit of a free ride, you could say. That bloody tree straight ahead, blocking all my favourite routes off. It's literally nice for me just to get back on a combustion engine, and yeah, it's put a smile on my face. See if we get up this bank there. It's a bit of a dream, this place to ride. There's no flat areas. Rain recently, it's made everything. knew that had happened, it bumped me. The weight came off my back wheel. Johnny, you are a bit green. What are you doing? Oh. Not even bike fit. So you're going for the best view you can find. Even though that was slow, it feels like a bit of a workout for me. You know, I'm not bike fit at the moment. And the only way you're gonna get bike fit is riding. But you don't wanna overdo it and pull a muscle or make a silly mistake and injure yourself. But it's like any sport, you can't get fit at boxing without getting in the ring and doing some proper boxing. Football, you can't get match fit without playing football. Same with bike, you can't get bike fit without riding. You can do all you want in the gym, but it's never going to replicate what you're going to get on your bike, especially if you're riding off-road in somewhere like this. It felt good riding that. I felt a little bit nervous, just a little bit twitchy, you know, not very familiar. The bike feels completely different to anything I've been riding recently, but I expected that. I'm just glad I've got this wood. You might have seen the swings over there. That's for my kids, and there's a bit of a cover. We often come up here. It's a bit of a dream, this place, for me. And you couldn't ask for more. Look at the terrain. Hopefully I've explained the situation and some people understand. So the pit bike content is coming back. I hope you enjoyed this upload, and thanks for watching the Murder Machines channel today.